Welcome back to our intermediate financial accounting class. Over the last few segments, we've been talking about the income statement, what it is, why it's important, how we make one, specifically a multi-step income statement, what the other formats are, and then in the last few segments, what do we do with those unusual line items that really don't fit with our normal day-to-day operations. We've already talked about several of them, and last time we talked about one of the more important ones, which is a discontinued operation. How do we decide whether or not we can really record something as discontinued? Well, we went through several examples and talked about how it has to be that we are getting out of the line of business completely. Not just changing location, not just changing inputs, but really 100% getting out of that line of business. We also decided at the end of our last segment that CBDS's example that you can see right up here really does qualify as a discontinued operation. What I've added now to this slide are the numbers that we were missing last time. So here's basically what happened. The companies decided that they are going to get rid of their shipping business, they're going to sell it off to FedEx or some other shipping company, and they're going to focus on their production. So definitely a discontinued operation. One of the reasons they're getting out of this line of business is because they lost a bunch of money. From January 1st to October 1st, they lost $200,000. That's a lot for a company of this size. One of the things we need to talk about before we go on are the two important dates in a sale of a discontinued operation. The first, the date of decision, the day we decided to get out of this line of business. In this case, that's October 1st when the company decided they were going to get rid of this business. The other date is the actual sale date, and that can happen immediately. Like if somebody walks in and says, hey, we'll take that line of business off your hands, oh, that's a great deal, we'll decide to do it and sell it right then, well, then you get both dates on the same day. A lot of times, though, it takes a long time to find a buyer, and you go through several different negotiations, and maybe it takes 2 or 3 years. So we're going to take a look at what happens for a lucky company like CBDS that's able to sell it within those first few months. Let's go ahead and jump back to Excel. It's $200,000 loss from operating until they made the decision, another $250,000 lost from October until they sold it, and then they made $400,000 selling this piece of equipment. The rule is we have to show three things with a discontinued operation. We have to show the amount we lost running the discontinued operation. We have to show the amount of the sale, whether we had a gain or a loss. And then we have to show the tax effect. One of the peculiarities of those below the line items, discontinued operations and extraordinary items, is that their numbers are not included in income tax expense as reported on the income statement. Instead, we break their income tax expense out and show it as part of the segment for discontinued operations and extraordinary items below the line. So really, we should call income tax expense from continuing operations, because that's all we're showing there, even though the account itself will have an actual balance with all of the income tax expense. So let's go ahead and take a look at this. Again, we have to show those three pieces of information. You've got several options on how you want to actually do this. I'm going to show you the one that's the clearest. You can also break it down and just use what we call a parenthetical note, where you put in the total number and then you put in a little, in parentheses, this is what these other numbers are. So let's go ahead then and do some calculations. Before the date of decision, they lost $200,000. After the date of decision, they lost another $250,000. So overall, $400,000 loss running this operation during year two. Then we sold it, and in the sale, we made $400,000. Now I want to figure out the tax effect. That's the third thing I need to know. We take the $450,000 negative, or loss, either way, plus that $400,000, and there's my effect pre-tax. Now we've got to figure out our taxes. If we go back to our raw data tab and scroll down to the bottom, you can see right down here that they have a 25% tax rate. So the easiest way to figure out taxes, if you think about this, if I said, hey, I'm going to give you $100 and you have a 25% tax rate, you wouldn't have to recalculate your entire income to figure out that you owe $25 in taxes. You could just take that $100 extra times the percentage, and that would be your tax. In this case, we're going to get a tax break, but again, I don't have to calculate the whole thing. I can just multiply it. So to figure out our tax expense, we're going to use the following equation. We're going to use a negative tax rate, and I always use a negative tax rate because if I had a gain, then I would owe more taxes, and the tax expense would be show up as a negative, so I want a negative number. If I have a loss or expense that's going to drop my net income, then I'd get a tax benefit or a tax break, and so my taxes would go down, and that would be a positive number. So I'm always going to use a negative here. So you can see I'm just taking that $50,000 times a negative tax rate, and that gives me my effect, and sure enough, it comes out as an income tax benefit, just like I expected it to. Now that we've done our calculations, we can put them into the income statement. So let's scroll over back to column M and add the discontinued operations section to our income statement. Looks like I need to scroll up just a bit. There we go. This is not net income anymore. Now that I'm adding a discontinued operations line, this becomes the line. The line is income from continuing operations, and not before taxes anymore, this is after taxes. So there we go. The other thing I've got to do is I've got to get rid of this double underline, because this is not an end number anymore. Remember, that double underline signifies the end of a financial statement, that everything balances, or that I've done a calculation and I'm finished. This is my final value. And that's not the case anymore. Now I've got this discontinued operation. So I'm going to come down a line, and we're going to put in discontinued operations. And again, there are three pieces of information that we have to include. So the first is the loss, or could be a gain. In this case, it's a loss on operating the discontinued segment. And let's go ahead and link that in. So equal to the $450,000 that I lost just trying to run this segment. Next, whoops, let me scroll over again. There we go. Next is our gain on disposal. And because Excel is having a hard time getting me back and forth, I'm just going to type this in, but you can certainly link it. We gained $400,000 on the sale. And finally, we'll have the income tax effect, income tax benefit. And that was $12,500. Again, the rule is we have to show these three key pieces of information. Doesn't have to be shown just like this, however. I could have put in the net amount and then put in parentheses, here's this number, and this number. And that works too. It just depends on what your preference is as the preparer of the financial statement. Now I've got the three numbers in, I need a net effect of my discontinued operation. Now you can make a separate line for that, but to keep it consistent with what I've done in the past, I'm just going to put it off to the side here in Q, row Q, or column Q. So we'll add these three up, and there's the net effect of my discontinued operation. $50,000 loss, but I'll get a tax break because of that, so my net effect is this $37,500. And now, I'm going to put in net income. And for now, net income will be this income from continuing operations minus that $37,500. And there's my double underline, because at this point, I'm finished. And that would be my final number with the discontinued operation. Now, there's one other possibility here, and that is what we call an extended phase-out period. The example that we just did, the phase-out period was short. It all happened within 1 year. I operated the segment, decided I was going to sell it in October, and by the end of the year, I had found a buyer, and I'd sold it off. Now, what if that had continued on into the next period, or into 2 years? What would we do? Well, it used to be that this was a very complicated procedure, and you have to estimate whether you thought you'd have an overall gain or loss and do all these fancy calculations, but now it's really simple. You only report what actually happens in any given year. Everything else, we wait and we disclose that in the future. So if you had an extended phase-out period, you'd have loss from operating the discontinued segment in this year, and in next year, maybe in year three, if you're still trying to find a buyer, and then in year four, hey, I finally found a buyer, I spent this much more during year four, and now I've got the sale, and I've got a gain or loss then. So we're not going to recreate the whole section here, but I do want to take a look at what it would look like if we had an extended phase-out period. Let's go back to our PowerPoint just briefly, and I'm going to add some extra details here. What happens if instead of selling it in year two, we sell it in January, the end of January of year three, and during that extra month, we lost another $100,000. What would we show? Again, we'll go back to Excel where we can do our calculations, and I'm going to scroll back over to the left, and you can see we've got this if this disposal in year three section all ready to go. So first, before the date of decision, again, we lost $200,000. That was one of the reasons we decided to sell it. We lost another $250,000 running it for the year. In year two, which is the financial statement I'm doing, I don't put in any gain on the financial statement because I haven't sold it yet. I'm not going to sell it to year three. So this is going to be a zero. And down here, my operating plus sale effect would just be the negative $450,000. So to get my taxes, I'm going to take that $450,000 times a negative, remember, so that it flips. We have a loss now, so it's going to be a tax benefit. So I'm going to use a negative 0.25 or 25%, however you want to type it in. And I'll have a $112,500 tax effect now. Now, we're not going to put that in our income statement. We're going to leave the income statement as is. But down here, you can see I've got a pretend segment that we can look at. So let's go ahead and fill this in, what it would have looked like if I hadn't sold this year. So let's see. I put in the 450 for the loss on operating segment. And I put in the $112,500 for the income tax benefit. And here's what I would show in my discontinued operations section. Now, we're not going to do this, but just so you know, the next portion of this would be, well, what happens in year three when you actually sell it? Well, in year three, you'd have a $100,000 loss from operating the segment during January, and then you'd have the $400,000 gain. So you'd actually show a net effect of a positive $300,000, and then you'd owe taxes on that $300,000. Kind of a bum rap in year three because you now have to show this tax expense, but you got a big tax break in year two anyway because you had such a huge loss in year two, no gains to offset it. So let's take a look right now at IFRS for discontinued operations. There's not a lot of differences between US GAAP and IFRS. You remember under US GAAP we have to show how much we made or lost running the operation, how much we made or lost selling it, and then the tax effect. Under IFRS, we only have to show the net amount on our income statement, or as they call it, a statement of profit and loss. We do have to include the other information somewhere, just not necessarily on the income statement. You can, but you can also disclose it in a footnote. So a little bit different in that they give you some flexibility with where you put that information. That's how we show discontinued operations in our income statement. That's what the calculations look like. That's what it looks like in the income statement. Now we're going to go ahead and take a look at one other adjustment, and we will do that when we come back. I'll see you then.